the holiday I celebrate is Christmas. In Tagalog, that is Maligayang Pasko. And during Christmas time, what we do in our household, since we're Filipinos and we try to carry on those traditions, we like to put a parol, which is a Christmas light that is homemade. And then we also do ampaws, which are red envelope that we give to kids that have money inside them. And then we also bake Filipino bread called bibingka that have salted egg in the middle on them.
So my family celebrates Christmas. We do a Christmas for my mom's side on the 24th and a Christmas for my dad's side on the 25th. In terms of traditions, my family's from Switzerland and Germany originally, so we have Brösles. It's a big cookie made in iron. You can split it into fourths. Tastes kind of like a cake ice cream cone. It's very delicious, in my opinion. And we also have rosettes, which are a puff pastry with powdered sugar on top. And we have Obstbrände Schokoladen, which is fruit brandy candies, or fruit brandy chocolates, which is a chocolate with a brandy in the center.
So a tradition I like to celebrate with my friends and family is called Nopetiao, which is in English translation, Eat 30. We have it all over the United States, like in California, Minnesota, Wisconsin, North Carolina. You know, a lot of people come together for that, called the Hmong New Year. You know, everyone, there's sports competition, dance competitions, singing. There's also gutsia and ball tossing. Everybody comes together, we're all dressed in Hmong clothes, or even in modern clothes. Honestly, it's to honor traditionally the ancestors of our Hmong people, but also it's just to embrace our culture once a year, because there's not a time where a lot of Hmong people can get together. So that's also why we have more than just one New Year in each state. So like I said before, California, etc. But yeah, how I celebrate it, I usually go with my friends and family. I'm usually watching the dancers, just supporting them and around the food, because Hmong people are really well known for their food as well. So yeah, that's how I mainly celebrate it with my friends and family.
So I celebrate a couple holidays. The first one would be Christmas. And the other one would be what we call Wise Men's Day. So for what we do for Christmas is we go the day before, so Christmas Eve, and we just help our grandma make some tamales. We make her help with other Mexican food. We prepare that in the morning, and then at the end of the day, we end up going to my uncle's house, having a party, and then we go home, watch Christmas movies leading up to Christmas Day, and then as soon as the clock strikes midnight, we open up our presents. And then we sleep the rest of the day in. For Wise Men's Day, we celebrate that on January 6th. So traditionally, that involves the wise men coming to baby Jesus, and that is kind of our version of St. Nick's Day.
The celebration we do is called Diwali. It is in the month of November, and it is the most important and the biggest festival of the year. Diwali symbolizes truth always wins by lighting up the lights when you are in a dark mode. So this festival has 5 days. Each day has its own significance. All the days is like self-development for yourself. And all days we come together close as a knit family. We do donations and we bring compassions to each others, and we move on with the new life. This is the day where we have our tradition in our house is called Rangoli. Rangoli is basically actually drawing in front of your house the designs by the chalk. And on that day, we have a competition. We all set up in a WhatsApp group. We send all other pictures, and whoever wins will get the trophy of a snapshot and the year below it. Actually, I have 3 trophies, and I love it, and I'm so proud of myself. Nobody has 3 trophies in a row.